Hachette Audio presents Inner Mastery, Outer Impact, How Your Five Core Energies Hold the Key to Success. Written and read by Hitendra Wadhwa, PhD. Dedication to my mother for the wisdom in her love, and my late father for the love in his wisdom. Introduction. You will never have a greater or lesser dominion than that over yourself. Leonardo da Vinci. The experience I will never forget. One day, in the pre-internet age, I drove from my home in Palo Alto to Yosemite National Park upon the invitation of two friends who were camping there. This was going to be my first time at Yosemite. I had not seen any photos of the park, so I had no idea what to expect. It was dark by the time I reached its gates. I was greeted by park rangers and given a map. A long and winding road took me to the valley within. As I drove the final stretch, a blanket of peace fell over me. My spirit began to soar, and my thoughts became clearer. Nature, with its gurgling brooks, rustling leaves, and starlit sky, was casting a spell. I arrived at my friend's campground in the pitch of darkness and was soon happily asleep, imagining we were in a lush meadow surrounded by hills. When I awoke and walked out of my tent at dawn the next morning, I was instantly awestruck. Towering, steep, barren rock formations shooting up towards the skies from everywhere. A waterfall roaring down from one of the mountains, the color green taking on a thousand hues, and vistas upon vistas. It was nature at its rapturous best. I had no idea this was the paradise I had entered the night before and so casually slept in. The sheer splendor of Yosemite Valley was breathtaking, and the feelings of grandeur and beauty it evoked have never left me. I recall feeling like I was in the presence of something divine. Now you're listening to this audiobook and will go on a drive of your own with me as your guide. Our path may be a bit rugged and sometimes winding, and we may not see much of anything for a while. But what if I told you that there is a wealth of peace, wisdom, love, and joy that awaits you at our destination? Your inner core, that whatever glimpses you get along the way, the little insights and inspirations, are but a drop in the grand ocean that lies in wait at the very center of your being, that this core already exists within you, ready to offer its treasures whenever you awaken to its presence, that discovering it will be even more awe-inspiring than arriving in Yosemite Valley. I have struggled to find a way to put this promise in words. So instead, I thought of sharing the feeling of transcendence I experienced that magical morning at Yosemite. Let our journey begin. My breakthrough moment. On one fateful day in the classroom, I finally figured out what I wanted to be when I grew up. It wasn't a professor who helped me get there. It was a student. You see, I was the professor. My search for a lifelong passion had already taken me down three paths: mathematics, management consulting, and entrepreneurship. By the time I joined the Columbia Business School faculty in 2004, it was now December 2005, and I was wrapping up my fall semester course on marketing strategy. I had developed a strong bond with my students. And recognizing that I might not see them again after the course ended, I felt a keen desire to impart to them the most valuable guidance I could. So before concluding my final lecture, I shared three personal stories and the lessons I'd learned from them. After class, a student, Minjun, came up to me and said, "Professor, thank you for your time with us this semester. But most of all, thank you for your personal stories today. Those were, for me, the most valuable learnings from the course." I was happy and dumbstruck. Through this parting comment, Min Jun had confirmed what I'd long felt as a nagging suspicion, that there was a big hole in what we were teaching at business school. We were teaching how to grow a startup, a product, an investment, or a new business idea to its full potential. But we were not teaching how to grow your own self to your full potential. We were teaching how to direct others, change others, motivate others, influence others, and inspire others. But we were not teaching how to direct yourself, change yourself, motivate yourself, influence yourself, and inspire yourself. We were teaching how to lead everyone else, but not how to lead yourself. Hitendra, I told myself that day, this is what you want to research and teach in the years ahead. 18 months later, after I had conducted extensive research, delivered a series of seminars, and built a whole new curriculum, Columbia allowed me to take a professional leap by formally offering a new course called Personal Leadership and Success. For both me and Columbia, this was a radical experiment. As I prepared to deliver my first class in the course in the summer of 2007, my mind retraced the steps that had brought me to this point. Outer me, inner me. I was 10 years old when I came across the story of the Indian Emperor Ashoka. He ascended to the throne after killing his brothers. As king, he waged war upon bloody war to bring other kingdoms under his subjugation, building a vast empire that swept across the Indian subcontinent. But that is not why he's revered by the people of India. One day, Ashoka stepped on the battlefield to witness the ravages of war. As he saw the wounded and the dead, the wailing widows and the orphans, his heart melted. He realized the folly of his ways and committed to never waging another war. He still planned to pursue success, but not the kind of success he had chased until that moment. He spent the rest of his life using his wealth to serve his people and propagate spiritual understanding throughout his kingdom. It is this reformed Ashoka, not the rapacious Ashoka, who reigns supreme in the hearts of Indians more than 2,000 years after his death. He is commonly known as Ashoka the Great. When I was a 10-year-old, my fascination with Ashoka stemmed from neither his former ferocity nor his latter nobility, but rather from his capacity to transform himself in one short life, from one to the other. It made me wonder, do I too possess seeds of remarkable transformation within myself? What is the greatest version of me that I could be? Ever since then, I have had a deep and abiding interest in exploring the highest achievements in human life and the inner and outer steps we can take to get there. India, the country of my birth, provided fertile soil for such tilling. It was in this land that timeless truth seekers forged the discipline of yoga, which cultivates the potential we all possess for perfection in action, thought, feeling, and spirit. It was in this land that a privileged prince renounced his luxuries and slipped out of his palace to embark on a lifelong quest for enlightenment, transforming himself into the Buddha. It was in this land that a remarkable lineage of 10 spiritual teachers distilled the notion of an ideal life into the simple, devotional, and service-oriented faith of Sikhism. And it was in this same land where another great faith, Jainism, perfected nonviolence into a discipline that could be practiced not only with other humans, but with all living beings, not only in action, but also in speech, thought, and intention. India has, from ancient times, sought to map the contours of human potential, only to discover that there are no limits to it at all. And whenever Indian civilization has encountered the prickly strands of foreign faiths, it has happily woven their finest threads into its own spiritual fabric. The Sufis, practitioners of a mystical branch of Islam, brought their intoxicating poetry and music to India, illuminating the human heart's capacity for a pure, universal, ever-expanding form of love, and fostering an even more mystical path by fusing their faith with India's. Mahatma Gandhi's epochal movement against British rule was as deeply influenced by Christ's teaching of love and forgiveness and the American transcendentalist's teaching of civil disobedience as by the Hindu prophet Krishna's teachings of non-attachment.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.